'Tis the season to be jolly. Seriously, considering 2020 is almost over. Hang tight. What is up, guys? Welcome back to another episode on Tuck TV. If this is the first time you're on our channel, we do all things guitar and all things metal. So give us a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button along with the bell icon for more updates from us. A while back, we had Divyam Saini from Chandigarh ask us how to go ahead and get a good tone from a cheap pedal. And that's what this video is going to focus on. This is a Boss DS1. It is considered one of the first distortion pedals to have been out in the market. It's been around since 1975, so donkey's years. You can get this in Amazon for about 5,000 rupees is what I've seen. Even lesser at your local guitar shop, much lesser in the used market. And in all its time, it has earned the reputation of being quite the mixed bag. I mean, there are some guitarists who stand by it and consider it a good, you know, piece of product. There are some who don't. I don't. In fact, I personally think it's more fuzz than it is distortion. And the only thing it's got going for it is the build quality, which is really, really solid. But then again, this is what I have, so this is what we're going to be using. I also want to make a very quick disclaimer. For this video, I'm not going to be using any additional amplifiers or cabinets or anything, you know, that involves additional money. Because firstly, bedroom jammer. At this point, we all are, pandemic considered. And also, not all of us have the, you know, opportunities of having nice fancy amplifiers. I will, however, be using some free VSTs, which involve IRs and equalization, so that we can, you know, sort of talk about, or rather how I would talk about rounding the tone off on this thing. So that's my disclaimer out there. Which also means if you're a bedroom jammer, or if you're planning to start up, you know, your bedroom jam studio, the one additional equipment that you might need to consider investing in, if you haven't already, is an audio interface. You get some pretty cheap ones in the market which will get the job done. You have the likes of, you know, Alice's SoundLink and the Behringer UCG-102. They're cheaper than this pedal, you know, and I know they're not the greatest options out there. But then again, neither is this. Now, the first thing you want to do is know what kind of guitar you're going to be using with this pedal. And by guitar, I'm talking about the pickups. Between actives and passives, the way the signal is going to respond with this is going to be very, very different. For the sake of this video, I will be using my Samick Avion 6 Greg Bennett, equipped with HB101102 pickups. They are not the hottest pickups, I know, but then my objective is to give this thing as much disadvantage that I can. Okay then, so guitar is all hooked up, and as you can see over here, this is the, you know, DS1 pedal that I've got connected over here. This is what the signal sounds like with the pedal off in bypass mode. And this is what it sounds like with, you know, the tone and distortion off. Now, the one thing you might want to keep in mind at this point is you don't want to go ahead and dial it all the way to 12. Because if you do, it's going to get muddy. So, of course, in order to make sure this doesn't get too noisy, I'm using G-gate. You know, that's the noise gate that I'm using in over here. And like I mentioned, dialing it all the way up isn't really going to help your tone, because these cheap processors don't use the greatest of capacitors. So after a point, the knobs don't really do anything apart from muddy up the tone. So what you might want to do is find what is a sort of sweet spot. With this at about 12 o'clock, you can now hear it's got a sort of nice fuzzy crunchy tone going on about it. So if you're into rock music, this thing is going to work really well for you. And then, of course, depending on the type of tone that you want, you can go ahead and dial it up further. I like, you know, my tone to be roughly at about, what is this, maybe 5 o'clock. And I like my distortion also in and around that. Maybe the tone would be a little more, and that helps me get sort of maximum out of this. So there you have it. Of course, it is getting some help from the noise gate, because if I turn that noise gate off, you can hear that there's a lot of background noise going on. Okay, now the next thing you might want to consider doing is with the pedal, no matter what you do, it does end up having a very grainy sound. And in order to round that up, you would ideally use a cabinet, but a cabinet is an additional piece of equipment which you don't want to use here. So in this particular case, you can consider getting yourself IRs. So I use NAD IR as my default IR loader. I am just comfortable with that. There's a ton of other ones that you can consider. And to save you the trouble of looking around, If you go into the description, you'll find a link, and in that link you have access to all our IRs that you use. So everything from, you know, artist signatures to different types of, you know, cabinets and all of that. There's everything you ever need and never need in that. So go ahead and download that and take advantage of it. They're all free. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to play this without the IR loader and with the IR loader, and you'll hear the difference. This is without. Then we turn this on. And you can almost immediately hear that the tones have been nicely cleaned up. Probably add myself a little bit more in terms of the level. And then again, like I said, you can go ahead and use whatever you want. You know, you can blend like I have, or you can use just a single cabinet and improve your tone. The next point you might want to keep in mind is using compression. Now, compression is a very, very huge topic on its own. So if you want us to do a video on it, more than happy to. I know there are other videos on the internet, but if you want one from us, happy to do it. Let us know in the comments. But if I have to sort of crash course it, compression is all about strengthening the weak signals and tightening the peak signals. Because if you don't compress and throw your instrument into a mix, you might be in situations where parts of, you know, the mix, your instrument is either dropping out or is getting drowned. So to avoid that, we do this. And it's sort of made up of four parameters. You have the threshold, which is where you want the compression to kick in. You have the ratio, which basically looks at how much compression you want kicking, whether you just want a light roll off or you want a very aggressive, you know, sort of limitation over there. Attack, which talks about how quick you want it kicking in, and release talks about how quick you want it kicking off. So here we go with compression, without first. So you can hear it sort of nicely fatten the tone, and this is what my compression looks like. This is the threshold where it's kicking in. And as you can see, I'm not doing an awful lot. It's not a very, very aggressive, you know, compression. It's just the default setting actually. The next couple of things that you can keep in mind to improve your tone is you can get yourself some additional VSTs. This is the Nembrini 808 overdrive, completely free to use, which is why I'm talking about it here. And if you activate this, this can give you a little more oomph into your tone. And you can, you know, tune this up the way you want. Nice little, you know, plug-in to use. There's a lot of, you know, usable tones as well. Presets, I mean, so you can get that. And lastly, you might want to look at equalization. Now, the thing with compression and equalization is they both have the options of having been done prior. So you can either compress and or equalize your signal before it goes in, or you can do it the way I'm doing it, which is in post, because I kind of have the tone that I want and then I want to sort of clean it up. So in this case, you can see I use the, you know, side sort of like a high pass and a low pass filter. So I dial out the 50 hertz so that the bass frequencies can breathe. The 10Ks so that, you know, have a slightly more focused tone. Bump it up a little bit at 5K for a little bit of oomph, and then I scoop it out a little bit in the middle because I like my tones a little mid-heavy. If you don't like it that way, or if you're doing extreme metal, you can scoop it out a tad bit more and you got the tone that you want. So let's hear it without EQ and then with. This is without EQ, this is just the DS1 pedal. And then equalized again. Now the funny thing about equalization is it may sound nice as is, but then when you put it into a mix, you'll have these frequencies sort of wrestling with other frequencies, and that's when your mix is going to get muddy. So definitely consider equalizing. Alright then, enough talk. Let's put this into a mix and see what it sounds like. I'm not going to be doing an awful lot, just a very, very basic cleanup in terms of, you know, equalization and compression. And you're just going to be hearing more or less the pedal in terms of what it sounds like. So check it out. We'll be right back. Alright guys, and with that, I come to the end of this video. What did you think about it? What are your thoughts? And what would you do differently? Go ahead and let me know in the comment section. Give this video a thumbs up if you like what you see. Subscribe to our channel. And this is Tuck TV signing off. Until next time, stay metal.